So for anybody who's unfamiliar with Tabby's star or Boyajian star, this was a star that was observed by the Kepler mission, where what Kepler does is it looks for planets by measuring the brightness of stars very precisely and looks for little dips in the light of planets going in front of them. And Boyajian star was discovered to have a very unusual pattern of change in its brightness that is now thought to be due to dust, but it caused this big stir in the literature because there was a dialogue about, you know, could this be the sign of, you know, large-scale alien engineering? And the source of this was that actually a group of non-scientists through something called a citizen science project called Planet Hunters was looking at these light curves, these measurements of the brightness of stars, and noticed this unusual piece of data, and had a whole conversation about it. And the published paper that originally came out didn't really have a good solution. And they had originally posited, well, maybe there's a giant cloud of comets around this star, and they're passing in front of the star and blocking it in unusual ways. And then another astronomer pointed out, well, you know, you could also create this same signal by having some sort of large structure that obscured the star in some way. And so this became a big splash and a big topic of debate. As of right now, one of the things that scientific team did was they took follow-up observations. So the Kepler mission was no longer looking at that particular star because it's now in a different phase of its lifetime. And so they've taken follow-up observations, and they do believe that the variations are due to dust around the star, which is not tremendously uncommon, but it is... the pattern of brightness that we see is just very unusual.
Could I ask you how recent that assessment is?
Because three weeks.
Because yeah. I thought this is wonderful, so I contacted Tabby and said, "Come and tell us about your star." And as of like November, it still looked like there were some pretty odd things, including the fact that the star itself is dimming over the last 100 years.
Oh yeah, this is another really interesting thing about it. You know, we tend to think of astronomy as being very modern, and in fact, you know, the ability to have these big telescopes with digital cameras, which is what essentially we use for astronomy on them, is a modern invention. But there's also all this older data that can go back 100 years from photographic plates, and there's a big project at Harvard to digitize those. And so there is this long-scale dimming pattern, just a gradual faintening of the star over time, in addition to these sort of stochastic, chaotic dimming events. But just earlier in January, they came out with a paper that said it was probably dust.